Welcome to the VEX Robotics Competition Referee Training Videos, designed for both referees and teams. This is Chapter 2, Before the Match. Before every match, there are three major jobs for the referees. One, you need to make sure the field is set up correctly. Two, you need to make sure the robots are set up correctly. And three, you need to make sure that you're set up correctly. VRC Turning Point must be set up in a very specific orientation. This layout can be found in the manual and is shown here. To prepare a turning point match, referees must verify the on-field placement of caps, balls, and flags. Four caps have balls on top of them. Four caps rest on top of balls. It is very important that the color facing up, the placement of the balls on top of or underneath them, their position in the center of the field tile, and the rotation are all correct. Flags start in one of three positions: scored for blue, neutral, or scored for red. When setting these up, make sure that the scored flags are fully rotated into position and that the neutral ones are resting in the detent. In the Robot Skills Challenge, the field is set up almost exactly the same, except now, things are feeling a bit blue. The flags are all scored for blue, and the caps all have the blue side facing up. One important note about field setup is that there is no specification for how tight or loose the net is. Event partners who are concerned about loose nets may remove slack if they want, but this is not a requirement. Also, if an event partner has a damaged net, they may repair it as needed, provided that retains the same functionality as a stock net. Teams should design their robots and strategies with this possible variance in mind. This is also a good time to remind teams and referees about Rule SG12, which states that any concerns regarding game object starting position should be raised with the head referee prior to the match. Team members should never adjust game objects or field elements themselves. Now returning to point number two, making sure robots are set up correctly. There are a few things to check here. Per Rule G3, each robot must start the match in a volume smaller than 18 inches wide, by 18 inches long, by 18 inches tall. If a robot looks like it's extending out too far, use a sizing tool to measure them. However, only do this if it's fairly clear to you that they're too big. You won't have time to measure every single robot before every single match. Also, teams can request measurements of their opponents, but you do not have to grant this request. It's your call as a referee if you think a measurement is required or not. Usually, it is not. This is a good time to note that VRC Turning Point has some restrictions on robot expansion once the match has started. See Chapter 9, Robot Expansion, for more details. Next, make sure that all robots have two license plates in accordance with R20. These plates must be on opposing sides of the robot, must be clearly visible and legible at all times, and must show the color that matches their alliance color for that match. Basically, it must be abundantly clear to referees at all times which color alliance the robot belongs to. If a robot does not meet these conditions and the team cannot fix it in a timely manner, the referee may ask for them to sit this match out. And finally, at the start of a match, each robot must satisfy the requirements put forth by SG1. This means that they must be touching their alliance's starting tile, not touching any other foam field tiles, and not touching any scoring object other than their preload. A ball is considered to be legally preloaded if it is touching the robot, not touching another robot, and is fully within the field perimeter. If a robot is not present for their match, then the head referee will place their ball randomly on their alliance starting tile. Once the field is set, referees should take their position around the field. In the ideal situation, you would have three referees per match. The head referee should stand behind the net so that they can see the whole field, and the scorekeeping referees should be stationed at the two corners of the field such that they can see the flags and posts. The corner referees are especially important this year in case a cap falls out of the field. More on that in Chapter 6. However, you should generally avoid having referees stand in front of the field, as it makes viewing very difficult for the audience. Referees should also check to make sure that all drive team members are students. Adults are not allowed to be drive team members, not even coaches, in the VEX Robotics competition. That's all for Chapter 2, but make sure you check out the rest of the videos that explore other refereeing topics.